Hi, let's talk about the laryngeal membranes and cavities. In this video, we'll discuss the intrinsic laryngeal membranes and their major features and functions. We'll also relate the anatomy of the larynx and surrounding structures to methods of gaining airway access. So there are two intrinsic laryngeal membranes. There are a pair of quadrangular membranes which rest superiorly, and then there is a singular conus elasticus, which rests inferiorly. Now, it's probably worth noting that these two sets of membranes are separated by the laryngeal ventricle. So this space here is going to separate the quadrangular membranes above from the conus elasticus below. Now, in this case, the posterior wall of the larynx has been incised and then abducted away so that we can see these features of the membranes. So let's look at the quadrangular membranes. So there are two quadrangular membranes, and these run between the arytenoid cartilage is and the thyroid cartilage and the epiglottis. There are two main features of these cartilages. Of these membranes. The first are the aryepiglottic ligaments. These aryepiglottic ligaments provide lateral structure to the laryngeal inlet. And the next are the vestibular ligaments, also known as the ventricular ligaments. These span the distance between the arytenoid cartilages there and the thyroid cartilage. These vestibular ligaments, when they're invested by mucosa, are known as the vestibular folds. They're also known as the false vocal folds. So there are two of these quadrangular membranes, one on either side, and their function together is to really funnel air into the larynx. Below the laryngeal ventricle, we have the conus elasticus. The conus elasticus's function is to funnel air out, specifically towards the rima glottidis. And let me clear all this out of the way. So the superiormost part of the conus elasticus on either side are the vocal folds running between the vocal processes of the arytenoid cartilages and the thyroid cartilage there. Those ligaments, when invested by mucosa, are the vocal folds. And below that, we have a couple of features. Laterally here, we have the lateral cricothyroid ligaments. And then medially here, we have the median cricothyroid ligament. So the two of these sets of ligaments are going to span the distance between the thyroid cartilage, the cricoid cartilage, and even the arytenoid cartilage. We'll see later how that median cricothyroid ligament comes into play with respect to managing an airway in an emergency. But first, let's take a look at the laryngeal cavities. So the laryngeal cavities are just spaces, and these spaces are going to be important if we're going to talk about airway management. So the path of gas exchange, let's just go one way in now. Air is going to come from the oropharynx and the laryngopharynx in through the laryngeal inlet, and the space there is the laryngeal vestibule. Now, inferior to the laryngeal vestibule, there's going to be two sets of folds. These are going to be vestibular folds or ventricular folds. They're the same thing. And then the space between those folds is the rima vestibuli. The air then can continue down, and it can pass through the laryngeal ventricle, which we can see there. And then there's another set of folds, the vocal folds. And the space between the vocal folds is known as the rima glottidis. Together, the rima glottidis plus the vocal folds is known as the glottis. Below the rima glottidis, so air is funneling through there, we have the infraglottic cavity. Which is continuous with the lumen of the trachea. So, in through the laryngeal inlet to the laryngeal vestibule, through the rima vestibuli, through the laryngeal ventricle, through the rima glottidis, through the infraglottic cavity, through the lumen of the trachea. Now, airway access can be achieved through some of these elements, and it really depends on if this is an emergent situation or if we're talking about long-term care. This is an emergent situation. One may perform a cricothyrotomy. In order to do so, you would palpate the laryngeal prominence, and then you would move inferior to that, and you can feel a little divot, and then you can palpate the cricoid cartilage. So that divot between palpatable elements of the larynx, one may incise the skin, and then deep to that, they would incise that median cricothyroid ligament. So that is a cricothyrotomy. It's a very straightforward procedure. There aren't any vascular elements in the way that are very problematic. There are palpatable landmarks. It is a very small airway that can happen, and it's also going to interfere with the elements of the larynx, so that's going to be somewhat problematic. So if the airway needs managed for long-term care, one may perform a tracheotomy, and by one I mean a surgeon can do this. This is done under surgical guidance in a sterile arena, and with a tracheotomy or a tracheostomy is one goes maybe 1 centimeter superior to the jugular notch there, and they can perform a longitudinal incision through the skin, and then they may move vascular elements out of the way. So here we can see the inferior thyroid veins draining the thyroid gland of blood down to that left brachiocephalic vein. We may have a thyroid ima artery, so about 10% of the population will have an artery in the way there, and that would be very problematic owing to the blood pressure in an artery. Or the thyroid gland itself may be very low, and that might require some management. So a tracheotomy is not something that is performed emergently. It's done surgically. And that leads us to our assessment question of the video, and that is, which space separates elements of the quadrangular membranes from the conus elasticus? Is it the infraglottic cavity? No. The laryngeal vestibule? Close, but no. Laryngeal ventricle? Yeah, sounds good. Rima glottidis? Close, but no. Rima vestibuli? No. Recall that the quadrangular membranes, their inferior-most parts are those vestibular ligaments. The superior-most folds of the conus elasticus are the vocal ligaments, and then the space between them is the laryngeal ventricle. C, final answer. Thank you very much for your time.